My challenge, guys, tonight, my assignment here tonight is to encourage all of you, to encourage each and every one of you, those on the floor, those in the back, those on the top, those in the nosebleed section. My assignment, my challenge tonight is to encourage every last one of you, from the youngest to the oldest, to get involved in ministry, to get involved in impacting the spiritual lives of those in our nation, our states, our communities, our cities, and our churches. So the question of the hour is, how do we pull this off? How do we make this a reality so that each and every one of us will leave here with the urgent plea on our hearts to get involved in ministry? Well, I want you to look at me with me tonight to the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 9. The Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 9. I want you to look at with me verses 35 through 38 of that chapter. Matthew chapter 9, verses 35 through 38 of that chapter. If you have it, please say amen.
Amen.
In fact, y'all can say amen all about my son. I'm kind of used to it. Y'all know what I'm talking about, all right? Y'all make me feel like I'm at home. Amen. Saying amen to a preacher is like saying secret to a dog. It really gets us going. It really does. Don't bother me at all. Don't bother me at all. So Matthew chapter 9, verses 35 through 38, you'll find these similar words. And Jesus went about all the cities and villages, teaching in their synagogues and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing every sickness and every disease among the people. When he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they were tarnished and were scattered abroad as sheep having no shepherd. Then he said unto his disciples, "The harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray therefore the Lord of the harvest, and he will send forth laborers into his harvest." Our Father and our God, Master, we thank you and we praise you for this wonderful and exciting privilege to be here tonight in Birmingham, Alabama at the Gridiron News Conference. Thank you for the invitation from Brother Phil. Thank you, Brother Charles, and the band who has blessed us in song. Now, God, bless this time of preaching. As always, Master, let me decrease as you increase. Father, let them not see bread, but God, let them see Christ. To then, God, that you may be glorified, the saints of God may be edified, Satan may be horrified, and sinners will come to repentance. Therefore, God, stand in my body, think with my mind, speak with my voice. I'll be careful, Lord, to give your name all the praise, all of the glory, and all of the honor. In Jesus' name we pray, and for the sake of the people of God, say amen.
Amen.
When he saw the multitudes, he was moved with compassion on them, because they fainted and were scattered abroad as sheep, having no shepherd. Therefore he said to them, "The harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few." With that text in mind, with that scripture in mind, with this occasion tonight in mind, I want to preach on the subject, what would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? The last 2 years that I served as president of the Southern Baptist Convention and traveled across this country, I was often asked, "Brother Fred, what's it going to take to reach our world? What's it going to take to reach our society? What's it going to take to reach our generation?" Since yesterday evening, the tragic shooting in Charleston, South Carolina, I've been getting calls from the news media, getting calls from people across the country, and asking me to address that need. What's it going to take